Illustrating History. Can you imagine a musician who can't hear? Well, that's exactly what happened to one of the greatest composers in history, Ludwig van Beethoven. He was born in 1770 in the city of Bonn, Germany. His father, a very strict man, gave him his first music lessons. At the age of 5, Beethoven showed great talent at the piano. When he was 8, he started taking lessons with the musician Christian Neef, who was impressed by Beethoven and gave him a formal musical education, enabling him to become a professional musician at the age of 11. When he was 16, he participated in a recital for the great composer Mozart, who was very impressed by the talent of young Beethoven. Although his career was promising, at home, he was going through some very difficult times. At a time when medicine was very limited, Beethoven lost 3 siblings when they were still babies. He also lost his beloved mother to tuberculosis when he was just 16. His father's alcoholism worsened, and even though he was still young, he had to become the head of the household and raised his younger brothers, Caspar and Nicholas. In 1792, at the age of 22, Beethoven moved to Vienna, Austria, which was the world capital of music, where the greatest composers of the time lived. In Vienna, Beethoven studied with great musical masters like Joseph Haydn and Antonio Salieri. There, he composed all his major pieces. But when he was 26, he started losing his hearing. Obviously, this left him deeply troubled, even embarrassed, and he kept his disability a secret for many years. But even while he was going through immense suffering, Beethoven continued composing. At the age of 54, in 1824, only 3 years before his death, he composed one of his most famous pieces, his Symphony No. 9. Rumor has it that while composing it, he would lay his ear over the piano to be able to hear the notes. And while his deafness might have prevented him from hearing his own music, driven by his love for his art and commitment to his talent, Beethoven has given the world compositions that will forever touch the hearts of all mankind.